This week, Susan Kamyab talks with the director and stars of the new indie film, Ruby Sparks.
Why do you think you're not writing?
I don't know. I get a good idea, and then, bam, I start thinking that is the stupidest thing ever.
The creators of Little Miss Sunshine brings us another brilliant film, this time about love. But it's not just your regular romantic comedy. And after speaking with the stars and the directors of the film, I found out what made them want to make this movie.
I'm glad you found something that inspires you.
Inspires me. It's like I'm falling in love with her.
That's wonderful.
I can't fall in love with the girl I write.
Why not?
Because she's not real.
I missed you in bed last night. Did you get some good writing done?
We wanted to do another comedy, but this felt like something very different from Little Miss Sunshine. So, you know, we liked that it had this almost science fiction element, that, you know, a fantasy girl, but that it still would explore a lot of very real emotions that we all experience.
And it kind of takes that whole idea of a fantasy girl to its logical extension, and we really loved that, that it wasn't just playing with the idea of a guy who creates a girl and he can make her do whatever he wants, you know?
We've seen that movie.
Yeah, we've seen that.
I think there are scenes in this movie that you have not seen in other films.
Yeah, we know.
Agreed.
Yeah.
We worked with Zoe for about 6 months on the script, and, you know, we kind of saw it like a roller coaster ride, you know, and we worked with her just to make the highs a little higher and the curves a little more scary, and, you know, so hopefully people will be surprised where the story goes.
Yeah, we hope it won't be, the press won't give it away too much. You know, it's always scary talking about it because it's hard not to talk about sort of where the story goes without, but you hope that it won't be given away.
Well, I plan on telling the end.
Always start with that.
Yeah, for sure. You two play such, it's such a cute relationship you two have in the film, at least the good times.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think it's easier to play a couple on screen when you're actually one in real life, or does that?
I'm going to say yes. I mean, I think at work it was great, and I hope that we could bring some kind of intimacy and chemistry to the characters, and I think Zoe and I trust and respect each other a lot, so the better my scene partner is, the better I'm going to be, and Zoe is a great actor, so that was all great. We had our little domestic things after a 14-hour day.
Driving home, you know, in LA traffic.
Sometimes
there was Chinese or pizza, whatever the thing was.
It was not without its challenges, but for the most part, I think it was good for the characters and good for the film. And we survived.
Thank God.
Thus far.
Yeah, no, you guys never had moments where you kind of wish that you had Calvin's power to like type out?
Well, I hope I've learned my lesson about that power. So no.
That's a good answer.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you could create your perfect mate, is that person just sitting right next to you?
Just say yes.
Well, I'm going to answer that more
Please,
seriously.
No.
Yes,
yeah,
I'm going
God.
To say that I think, you know, a part of what the movie's about is that there is no perfect person. That part of really loving someone is actually seeing their imperfections and not, like, just accepting them, but dealing with them, sort of dealing with your reactions to them, and when you wish that your partner was a different way, it actually speaks more about something in you than it does about them. And that's been, you know, something that I think, we've been together almost 5 years, I feel like I'm learning things about Paul all the time, and the relationship changes all the time, and to have that be a good thing instead of a scary thing, I think is one of the challenges and one of the great rewards of a relationship.
Are you mad at me?
Remember how Dad used to say I had an overactive imagination?
That's good.
Calvin, but there's no possible way that Ruby's in your house because she's not a real person.
Ruby Sparks will not only make you see your relationships differently, but you'll appreciate them much more. Don't miss this amazing film.
Kiss me, stupid.
There's got to be some logical explanation.
People don't appear out of thin air.
She did.
How?
I don't know how. It's love. It's magic.
Have you tried writing more? Write something about her and see if it comes true. If it does, this is a miracle.
Ruby Sparks is playing an exclusive engagement at Cinemark Tinseltown in Plano.